China has built the most powerful radio telescope on Earth, a machine designed to listen deeper into space than ever before. And if you've read The Three-Body Problem or watched the Netflix series, you might be thinking, is this really such a great idea? But don't worry, this telescope is not planning to send any messages. It's built to find hidden stars, map distant galaxies, and help us understand the universe like never before.
China is set to complete installation work on its 500-meter aperture spherical telescope known as FAST.
China has been making steady moves in science and space exploration over the past few years. In 2019, China's Chang'e 4 mission became the first ever to land on the far side of the moon.
A Chinese spacecraft has made the first successful landing ever on the far side of the moon.
A feat hailed as a major step toward the country's wider ambitions in space. By 2021, China had also landed its Zhurong rover on Mars, making it only the second nation to successfully operate a rover on the Red Planet. From landing a rover on Mars to building its own space station, the country has made it clear that it wants a bigger role in the global scientific community. But one project stands out, not just for its size, but for what it could mean for the future of astronomy. This is the 500-meter Aperture Spherical Telescope, better known as FAST. It's the largest and most sensitive radio telescope on the planet. At 500 meters across, it's the largest single-dish radio telescope ever constructed. To put that into perspective, it's wide enough to fit almost 30 soccer fields inside. Before FAST, the title of the world's largest went to the Arecibo Observatory in Puerto Rico, which measured 305 meters across. FAST is not just bigger. It's also about three times more sensitive. The telescope is located in a natural depression in the mountains of Guizhou Province in southwest China. This site was not chosen randomly. The surrounding hills help block out radio signals from nearby cities, and the remote location keeps electronic noise to a minimum, two things that are critical when you're trying to catch faint signals from deep space. FAST works by collecting radio waves from the universe using a huge dish made up of 4,450 individual triangular panels. These panels can shift slightly to change the shape of the surface, allowing the telescope to focus on different parts of the sky without having to move the entire structure. Suspended above the dish is a receiver cabin held in place by a system of cables and towers. This cabin moves to stay aligned with whatever object the telescope is observing at the time. Its frequency range is broad, covering signals between 70 megahertz and 3 gigahertz. That allows FAST to study a wide variety of cosmic phenomena, from nearby pulsars to distant galaxies. The real question now is, how exactly was this massive telescope built? What can it actually do? And is it truly as powerful as everyone claims? Let's break it down. China didn't build the world's largest radio telescope just to say it has the biggest one. There's a much bigger goal behind FAST: to push the country's capabilities in science and technology, and to open new windows into the universe. One major reason is the search for pulsars. Pulsars are rapidly spinning neutron stars that send out beams of radio waves. They act like cosmic lighthouses, and finding them helps scientists study everything from the structure of our galaxy to the behavior of extreme matter. It is so sensitive that it can pick up weaker pulsars that older telescopes missed. In fact, within just a few years of testing, it had already discovered over 500 new pulsars, a number that took other telescopes decades to reach. Another key goal is mapping neutral hydrogen in the Milky Way. Hydrogen is the most common element in the universe, and it plays a major role in the formation of stars and galaxies. By creating detailed maps of where hydrogen gas is located, FAST helps scientists better understand how galaxies evolve over billions of years. It is also keeping a close watch on something that's been puzzling astronomers for years: AST radio bursts, or FRBs. These are extremely brief but powerful flashes of radio energy coming from far beyond our galaxy. No one knows exactly what causes them. Some FRBs repeat, while others seem to be one-time events. Because of its ability to pick up faint and quick signals, this gives researchers a better chance of studying these mysterious bursts in real time. And then there's the search for extraterrestrial life. While it's not the primary focus of the telescope, FAST is scanning the skies for unusual radio signals that could suggest intelligent life elsewhere in the universe. China is participating in international programs like Breakthrough Listen, using this telescope as one of the tools to conduct some of the most sensitive search for extraterrestrial intelligence surveys ever attempted. Beyond astronomy, it is also advancing technology. The techniques developed to control its active surface and manage huge volumes of data are likely to influence future communications and signal processing fields as well. So while it's easy to focus on the sheer size of FAST, the real story is in what it can do. Capturing signals that are billions of years old, uncovering hidden parts of our galaxy, and maybe even hearing something entirely unexpected. But beyond the scientific goals, there's a strategic angle too. China sees this as part of its broader effort to become a leader in high-end science. After years of relying on other countries' research, China is now building its own world-class facilities and inviting others to come and work with them. So the real reasons behind FAST are a mix of scientific ambition, national pride, and a desire to play a bigger role in the future of space exploration. So, now the question is, how did they build this massive telescope? Building the world's largest telescope wasn't just about scaling up the size. It brought a whole new set of engineering challenges that had never been solved before. The first step was finding the right location. Engineers needed a place far away from cities, with natural protection from radio noise. They eventually chose a remote karst depression in Guizhou province, a bowl-shaped valley surrounded by mountains. The shape of the land made it easier to support the massive dish without having to build an artificial structure underneath it. But even then, preparing the site was not simple. Workers had to clear away trees, move tons of earth, and modify the terrain without disrupting the natural environment more than necessary. Then came the challenge of the dish itself. FAST's surface is made up of 4,450 triangular panels. Each one can shift slightly, pulled by a complex network of cables and motors. This allows the telescope to change the shape of part of its surface to focus on different parts of the sky, a feature that sets it apart from older telescopes like Arecibo, which had a fixed shape and could only observe objects passing directly overhead. Above the dish, a receiver cabin is suspended by six massive towers. Instead of being mounted on a solid structure, the cabin hangs from cables and can move with incredible precision. It shifts position depending on where the telescope is aimed, staying aligned with the section of the dish that's currently active. Designing a system that could hold such a heavy structure steady, while also allowing it to move smoothly, was one of the biggest engineering hurdles the team had to solve. Construction officially began in 2011. Over 9,000 residents living nearby were relocated to maintain the radio quiet environment, a decision that drew some criticism but was considered necessary for the telescope's performance. By mid-2016, the final panel was installed, and it saw its first light shortly afterward. Full operations began in 2020, after years of careful testing and calibration. The Chinese government spent around $269 million in poverty relief funds and bank loans for the relocation of the local residents, while the construction of the telescope itself cost $180 million. Compared to what it would cost to build a similar facility in many other countries, FAST was surprisingly affordable. When you look at it from the ground, it barely seems to move. But behind the scenes, thousands of tiny adjustments are happening constantly, all working together to let the telescope hear the faintest whispers from the farthest reaches of space. And it is not just a national achievement for China. It matters on a global scale, for science, for technology, and for how international research is changing. One big reason is its role in scientific collaboration. In 2021, China opened FAST to scientists from around the world. Researchers can now submit proposals to use the telescope for their own projects, whether they're studying pulsars, hunting fast radio bursts, or mapping hydrogen clouds across galaxies. Access is competitive and time slots are limited, but opening the facility marked an important step toward making this telescope part of the global scientific community. Another reason is what it represents in the bigger picture of space science. After the collapse of the Arecibo Observatory in 2020, there were real concerns about losing the ability to do certain types of radio astronomy from Earth. FAST has filled that gap, and in many ways, surpassed it. For many types of observations, there's simply no other instrument in the world that matches this telescope sensitivity right now. There's also a strategic dimension. It is part of China's broader investment in high-end research. Along with its space station, lunar missions, and Mars programs, China is clearly signaling that it plans to be a long-term leader in science. Finally, there's the inspiration factor. Projects like this don't just push the limits of technology. They also inspire new generations of scientists and engineers. Especially for countries in Asia, Africa, and South America, having access to a world-class facility like this creates opportunities that were once out of reach. So while it's tempting to think of FAST as just another big telescope, the reality is much larger. It's already shaping how research is done, who gets to lead it, and what kinds of discoveries might come next. For all its strengths, it hasn't avoided criticism. One of the biggest controversies was the relocation of thousands of people who lived near the site. To maintain the radio quiet environment needed for the telescope to function properly, the government moved over 9,000 residents out of the surrounding area. While compensation was offered, not everyone was satisfied with how the process was handled. Some people felt forced out of their homes, and others argued that the cultural and economic impacts on the region weren't fully considered. Maintaining such a huge telescope also comes with challenges. A structure this large requires constant monitoring and upkeep. The suspension cables, the moving receiver cabin, and the delicate surface panels all need regular maintenance to keep the telescope performing at its best. Over time, even small issues could affect its sensitivity. Running a facility like this isn't cheap either, and long-term funding will always be a factor. Another challenge is global competition. While FAST is the largest single-dish telescope, new projects like the Square Kilometer Array, a massive international radio observatory under construction in Australia and South Africa, could eventually outpace FAST in certain types of research. Even with these criticisms, there's no denying that it has achieved something few projects ever manage. It has pushed the technical limits of what's possible and created new opportunities for science. But like any major project, it comes with trade-offs that will need to be managed carefully over the years ahead. Now it's your turn to think about it. If you had a day to point the telescope anywhere in the sky, what would you focus on? Would you search for new galaxies, scan distant stars for signs of life, or hunt for the next mysterious signal nobody can explain yet? Let us know in the comments below. We'd love to hear your thoughts. And as always, thanks for watching. See you soon in our next video.